Good morning and welcome to the Rock and Roll Real Estate Hour starring Gary Rossignol of Prudential One Realtors. To be part of the program, dial 513-749-1480 to get answers to questions about your home and property. That number again is 513-749-1480. And now, here's Gary. Realtors,
and we are having our first annual Christmas open house, open microphone on the Rock and Roll Real Estate Hour here. And I'm just so excited. We just got off to a great start so far, and this is just really getting good. I have my dear friend Ria Davidson.
Hi, Gary.
Hi, Ria. Love you.
Love you right back.
And we've got Corey, right? Say hi.
Say hi.
Okay. And Julia.
Hello.
And these are a couple of your star Dragonfly kids.
They are, and we've got Santa Claus like right out of the booth. So
Santa Claus,
everybody wave. Like,
come in here, Santa Claus. Let's get a big ho ho ho.
Ho ho ho! Merry Christmas!
Hey, Santa Claus, how are you doing?
Good. Just busy this time of year.
That's right.
Sure.
Hey, somebody, they knew I was going to be interviewing you on the radio, and they wanted me to ask you, some people in my office, what's the market like up in the North Pole?
Well, it's just like it is everywhere else. It's a little slow up there.
I bet it's cold, huh?
Yes.
You got your reindeer parked out front?
No, they're up on the roof.
Are they? Okay. You brought gifts for all these kids?
Yes, we've also been working very special for the North Pole. We wanted to do something special for the boys and girls here today.
All right, great. Well, we appreciate that. Did you meet Santa Claus yet? Did you?
Yeah.
All right. Did you meet him?
All right. Yeah.
Is this fun or what?
Yes.
Is there anything you guys want to say to your friends who might be listening?
Listening.
Oh, my. Well, we're going to record this, so you'll be able to show them later.
Oh, yeah,
so
we can play it back.
You want to say hello?
Just talk straight into it.
You want to say hello to anybody special?
Really, just some friends and family back in West Virginia.
West Virginia.
That's where you're from, Julia? All right, great.
Well, and I'd also like to, just from my perspective, say thank you to the men and women serving in the military,
yes,
who aren't able to be with their families over the holidays, and mm-hmm. we are so grateful to every moment they spend protecting us and allowing us to live the life we live here.
Yep, so. Absolutely. Yep. Tell us a little bit about the Dragonfly Foundation.
Sure.
This is your moment.
Oh, my moment of glory. The Dragonfly Foundation brings comfort and joy to kids and young adults who have cancer and blood diseases. But it's more than that. It's not just the kids, the patients, it's the families. We try to find opportunities for them to go to Cyclones games, like, you know, Julie and her family did last night, and meet the players and have some time to be together and meet other families who are experiencing the same things that they're going through. It's a great opportunity to just be normal, because you haven't had a great time.
Yeah. Julia, you have any brothers and sisters?
I have three sisters and two brothers.
Wow. And what's your situation right now?
My sister had cancer 5 years ago.
Your sister did? Okay.
She's in remission now.
Okay, great.
She's almost hit her five-year mark. But I have to tell you a story about Julia's mom. They came here from West Virginia and attended a game with us last night. And while I was on the phone with the dad, Jamie, he works for the VA, and he made a point of telling me that he could work anywhere in the country as part of the VA. They could transfer if they wanted. And he said, you know, in our wildest dreams, we would love to move to Cincinnati to volunteer for the Dragonfly Foundation.
Wow.
And I tell you, it still gives me chills. And mm-hmm. You know, that here, Shelly, who's over there waving at me, it has that kind of spirit in her that the Dragonfly Foundation would move her to even say something like that to me.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So I'm just grateful.
Now, how many kids did you bring down today?
We have 10 kids here today.
Wow.
Yeah, we have 10 kids.
They've never been in a radio studio before, huh?
No, it's great. And, you know, we had a Kings Island event over the summer where we gave microphones to the kids. And they take a little while to warm up, but trust me, they'll be singing before long. Yeah. We had them tell knock, knock, do you know knock, knock, joke, Corey? What knock, knock, joke can you tell?
It's got to be
knock,
clean.
Knock.
Who's there?
Who's there?
How long
who?
How long until we get to go to celebrate Christmas with you with the other children?
Oh, that's a good one. That's a good one.
That's great. That's great. Corey, you have any brothers and sisters?
Yes, I do.
How many?
I got three out there.
Oh, they're out here too?
Uh-huh.
Oh, wow.
Two of them's out there, and one's about to be my stepsister, and one of my other brothers lives with his dad.
Okay, great, yes. Great. So what's your situation?
I had a tumor back in 2008, I think.
Okay.
And
you're in remission now?
Yeah.
Great.
I have blind because of the fluid around the tumor either enlarged or crushed my ventricles.
Wow. So you have a lot of beads?
Yeah.
How many beads do you have? Beads of courage.
Why is he doing that?
Do you have
a lot.
You do. Why don't you explain the beads of courage?
Sure. How would you describe the beads of courage, Ryan? You want to do it? You want to explain what that is? What happens when
I can't really explain.
Okay. Well, when kids get admitted to the hospital for treatment, they get a length of string with their name spelled in beads, a children's hospital bead and a Dragonfly Foundation bead. And as they go through procedures, they get different beads that represent that procedure. So like radiation would be a glow-in-the-dark bead. They would get a bead if they lose their hair. And as they go through different procedures, those kind of accumulate, and it's a way to tell the journey of, you know, what they've been through, and to look back and say,